I need the place quiet, so go Cyclones! I thought everybody would be quiet on that one. Anyway. I lost a lot of people. Anyway, I thank everybody for being here. The roads and everything. And it's been beautiful. I don't need to wait. I just can't remember what I'm going to say. I know the Mass was probably long for some non-Catholics or whatever, but hopefully you all opened your hearts and got the Holy Spirit in it. It's the same Holy Spirit, it's just a different house, you know? So, and it was beautiful. I tell you what, that wedding was beautiful. It really was. Makenzie wanted to hand out communion, so she'll be able to remember that the rest of her life. And so there you go. Cheers. Second of all, somebody said, hey, you going to call Blake's son? I says, hell no. I would not want to take that away from Randy and Ann, because he's a beautiful kid, and they're his parents. I would call him son-in-law, or better yet, I would like to call him friend. Except, I've got two son-in-laws that I also call friend. One wants to take me to a nursing home, and the other said he'd drive them. So I really don't know about the friend thing. I've been married 35, 36 years to Heidi. And, cheers! But I learned something from the newlyweds today. They get up and they say to each other, what are your expectations of the day? And then they say, Makenzie will say hers, and Blake will say hers, and then they get together and they, no. It's not like the married guy. Ron, these are my expectations of you today. So that's great. I just think everyone can learn from Blake and Makenzie on that. All right, we had like four meet and greets. We had quite a few meet and greets. I'm just going to tell you about a couple of them. One, Blake, second time I met him. We were barbecuing, and then he spilled something on his shirt and had to get the stain out. So he put Heidi's Hawkeye shirt on. Woo! And all the littles are running around and everything, and I'm going to make it short. After they left, the second time I meet him, I thought we could play cards together. You know, that's nice. And he could be my partner, you know. Because I win and he's competitive, I know. So the night went on and it got too late. Everybody went home. They're going down the hill. I text him and said, thanks for coming. Seriously, thanks for being here. Hope you had a good time. He texts me back and says, I'm confused. I said, confused about what? He says, well, I've got your wife's shirt on and you want me to be your partner. So I knew we'd get along from there on in, I guarantee it. And the people that helped build Blake and the character that he is today are three people. And we'll start with Ann. We went to the Jasper Winery with Ann to meet and greet. I don't know, their family wants to meet and greet. But now they met me, they kind of don't want to, right? All right, I just saying. See, I told you, it's there. But anyway, we went to the Jasper Winery, had nice wine, listened to good music, and we learned something about Ann that night. You know, you always learn something. And we learned how many sangrias Ann shouldn't have. Next time we went and met Ann, Randy. Randy and Val, he was a little late. He was putting on his cowboy boots, but we waited for him. We went to that Smash Park thing. You know, it's got a bunch of games and stuff. And they got a ping pong table. Oh, my gosh. Ping pong. Heidi's ears, you know, stick up like Spock. You know what I'm saying? And you know what? Randy's does, too. Big ping pong player. So anyway, they're in the tournament. Val's standing next to me. They're playing. Heidi turns around. First game. Should I let him score? Hell, I don't know. She's got to sleep with him tonight. I don't know. You know? I don't know. So anyway, the second game got a little closer. So we learned something there, too. What we learned was, if you beat Randy in ping pong, all you're going to hear the rest of the night if he doesn't have his sandpaper paddle. That's what we learned. My alarm clock went off and said Randy should have had his sandpaper paddle. I am not kidding you. Oh, no. Here's last but not least. Here is last but not least is Papa Leo. has not met this guy. Whoa, you're missing out. Everybody needs to meet Papa Leo before this night's over. So this is the first time I met Papa Leo. I learned something here. Papa Leo, I walk out, I'm getting up, I'm going in his garage. He's sitting in his garage. He gets up, and he starts walking toward me. And I shake my head. He goes, hey, Heidi, how are you doing? I said, what the hell? I love this place, man. They start drinking before noon, too. Now, I tell you what, you know, you're around some people. I told him I'd pay him back. I told him I'd get him back, you know. I'd pay him back for that. And I said, well, anyway, you can be around some certain people, and being around that certain people, you know, that person, makes you a better person. Papa Leo ain't nothing like that. I said he wasn't nothing like that, but you guys went the other way. I love it. I thought I could pay him back, and you guys blew me out. So anyway, so then he goes, and there's two things he does. He goes in the grocery store, and he gets a gallon of milk, because all the girls come up to him, say, hey, Papa Leo, how you doing? Rub his back, give him hugs and stuff. You know, then he just gets a gallon of milk, and at 2 o'clock, he goes back up to the store. He's the most eligible bachelor in Colfax, for crying out loud. So at 2 o'clock, he goes in there, and he gets a loaf of bread, because they have a shift change of the girls at noon. One sentence that caught me off guard, he says, Ron, I thought this was kind of out of characteristic from him, but he says, Ron, I always wanted people to look up to me. And I said, you did? Yeah, I always wanted people to look up to me. That's why I built my home on top of a hill. Everybody needs to meet this guy. So at last, closing, I just hope everyone, Blake and Mackenzie's expectations are to help each other every day to try to get to heaven. Thank you. Cheers. And Randy, Blake's dad, is going to lead us in a prayer. And then we're going to be able to eat. Thank you all for being here, and drive safe.
Well, I can't top that one, but I know everybody's hungry. And on behalf of Makenzie, Blake, the Reed family, and the Fitch family, I want to thank everybody for coming and sharing this moment, this evening, in the union of Makenzie and Blake. They're just such a beautiful couple. Anyway, if we could all bow our heads, I'll lead us in prayer. Heavenly Father, we come to you asking your blessing and favor on Makenzie and Blake. We pray for patience and tolerance and understanding as they begin to adjust to the wedded life. May theirs be a home where there is much joy, laughter, support, and an atmosphere of acceptance and safety. We pray that they will always respect each other, and may both of them enjoy the freedom to become all that you want them to be individually and as a family unit. Grant them courage to choose God's instructions in a world that often abandons these. May their trust in you increase. May their home be filled with your peace. We ask this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Alrighty, friends and family, the host and the hostess will be dismissing tables, starting with the head table, so please do not cut in line, please do not just get up. Sit patient. Alrighty, friends and family, if I get your attention, we're going to get started here with speeches tonight. Up first, we got the Sisters of the Bride. We got Mallory and Nikki. Make some noise.
Okay. Well, we are sisters of the bride. Yeah.
I'm Mallory, mom's favorite.
This is Makenzie, dad's favorite. And I'm Nikki. Okay, as a little sister, you had some pretty big shoes to fill. And we just want you to know that, with that being said, you have always been hardworking, independent, and very selfless.
Sorry, I'm not hiding the phone. We admire your strive in life, your passion for adventure, and we couldn't be happier that you found someone that not only shares those passions, but also enhances them as well. Blake, we wanted to give you a couple of tips as to how to be married to a Reed girl.
First and foremost, Sundays are for God and family.
Now that you married Makenzie, you not only get her, but you get all of us.
Is this about mom? The other thing that you need to know is mom taught us very well. Anytime this girl goes shopping, she's going to hide every shopping bag in the car until you're sleeping. Also, every time you get gas, take out $5 to $10 extra in cash so he doesn't know where that money's going.
Yeah, we're drinking, but it's still true, Mom. Just so you know, we don't ever stick to a plan. Grandma Reed's vodka slush, short sheeting beds, Reader's garden tours, and Christmas caroling on Uncle Barney's bus are just a few traditions that you're going to be a part of.
But better who to give you advice than our husbands. When we asked Mo and James how best to be married to a Reed girl, Mo's first and foremost answer was, invest in a good pair of earplugs.
And James's advice was to get along with Reader. And good luck.
You have been an answer to our prayers. And may God live in your marriage.
We love you, brother. Now, everybody, please raise your glasses to the new Mr. and Mrs. Fitch! Woo-hoo!
Just calm down, Jeff. Calm down. I know you guys all know that my brother sweats a lot, and it doesn't fall far from the family tree. I sweat a lot, too, and I'm a little nervous right now. But what I want to say is that my brother's been there from day one. He's, you know, when we were younger, we weren't as close. But I swear to God, as soon as he hit his teenage years, he was looking out for me, and I needed it. There's no doubt about that. He did. A lot of times he went out of his way to make sure that I was happy. He made sure that my happiness was first and foremost. So I can't thank him enough for that. I know he wished that our grandma could be here today, and she's looking down on us today. I know that for a fact. She's very happy to see you marrying somebody who, perfect. You guys are perfect together. So she's, well, imperfection, you know, two of them, they make perfect. Anyway, I've never seen my brother in the past, since he's met Makenzie, I've never seen my brother as happy on a daily basis as he has been. Like, this is a side of my brother that I have never seen, and I'm so happy for him. It really is. I mean, he's committed. He's 100% into this, and I'm so happy for him. So I wish you guys the best and lifelong happiness. So.
I've never seen you with glasses on. I don't know how you drive, to be honest. Legally. No, seriously, me and Blake, we've been... I didn't grow up with a kid, but as soon as we met each other, we hit it off, we're best friends or whatever. He's hands down one of the best guys I've ever met in my life. And you are... You turned his life around, because he was going down a bad path. Thank you, and he's your problem now.
All right, I'll keep this really, really short. My name's Kyle. I met Blake in college, and we were just acquaintances, and then over a long, long poker game, he became my roommate. And I tell you what, Blake, been through a lot, you and I. A lot can't be talked about, a lot of Vegas trips. A lot of late-night hotel rooms, you know. Blake was always the first one back, though, by the way. But tell you what, though. Before we go any further, ready? Makenzie, hold your hand up. Okay. Hold your hand up. Blake, put your hand on top. Does everybody see that? That will be the last time that Blake has the upper hand ever. Glasses up. Mr. and Mrs. Fitch. Congratulations.
First of all, thank you guys. You made me sweat again. Not the first or the last. Ladies, I'm so happy that you're my sisters. Thank you. I've never had one. I've only had this one.
He's happy, I'm not.
But seriously though, thank you all for coming. Thanks for sharing this day with us. It's been the best day of my life. Hopefully, she thinks the same. But we want to thank our parents, Heidi, Ron, Dad, Val, my mother, Ann. You guys have been nothing but exceptional to us. You guys have done everything that we could ask for. You guys planned all of this, particularly Heidi. So, cheers to that.
Go State.
But no, we're very thankful to have all of you here. There's a reason why you're here. You mean a lot to us. We couldn't be where we're at without all of you. at some point in our lives. And I'm blessed to have her, this beautiful wife, who I met in an airport going to Vegas.
He played his cards, right?
I played my... I want to thank all of you. I love you all. Thank you for being here.
You just did. Okay, well, I have to say something nice. Like Blake said, thank you all for traveling near and far. He already thanked the parents, but it's been, we're just hashtag blessed to have the greatest, so thank you. Uncle Barney, where are you at? Thank you for the party bus. We got our group on. But honestly, from friends to family, we would not be where we are today. I know people say that all the time, whatever, but we really would not be here if it wasn't for all the past and the present. So we appreciate it, honestly. So thank you. We want to say thank you, and we just can't wait to have a great time tonight. So cheers to the Mr. and Mrs. Fitch. That's me. Take the microphone away. Thanks.
All right, friends, here in about 15, 20 minutes, we need to clear out the dance floor, make some room for some dancing here tonight. We can start with some first dances here in a little bit, and then open dance floor, we'll have a party tonight. We got one more person like to say something.
This is for Miss Makenzie Fitch.
All the bridesmaids on the dance floor, please.